right, here we are at NAMM. I'm happy to be sitting down. This is really, really nice.
On a Lego wall.
Yeah, I like the Lego wall too. We're here at obviously the JHS booth, and there's a lot of noise. There's a lot of people coming down because you guys have a lot of stuff coming out this year. What do you have on the bench?
Yeah, we've got a lot. So you want me to go down the line?
I'm waiting. I'm excited.
All right. Here we go. So 5 new NAMM releases. Let's talk about these three together. They're our analog tap tempo group. So the common thread is all analog Bucket Brigade time-based effects with tap tempo and modern amenities. So the Emperor, you've seen that in a bigger enclosure. It's shrunken down, an improved low-end response, and a better tone control. You know, this has tons of features, but true Bucket Brigade chorus. So think like CE2, Arion SCH1, Boss VB2. All in a package there. Then the Unicorn, still to this day, it's the world's only bulb-driven photo cell vintage Univibe with tap tempo. That's a mouthful. So it's the real deal. It's what Hendrix used. You know, it's the light bulb is in there pulsing, and we're controlling it with tap, expression jacks.
You managed to fit it in the smaller.
Yeah, it's a Unicorn Univibe. It's a wonder of the world. And so then this guy is totally redesigned. So the Big Panther, you know, years and years ago, we put that out. Then we shrunk it down to the Cub. Then we had a 1.5 Cub. This is the version 2 that I always envisioned getting to. It just took forever. So totally redesigned in the best way. So Bucket Brigade, we added an EQ control so you can go dark or bright. We added a volume preamp control. We made the Runaway really smooth. You can do all the old glitchy spaceship Runaways now. You couldn't do that before. Modulation is on the side. We freed up room on the pedal for more knobs, and it's just killer. It'll do big ambient soundscapes now where you can get out there with the 1 second of delay time. Really cool. Then Andy Timmons Plus. So this is the same thing as his Andy Timmons Drive that's been our most popular pedal of last year by far. And we added in a custom boost I designed for Andy to hit the front end. Because when you have raging Marshall distortion and you want more gain, like Andy, you have a boost now. Right here, this is 3 years of my life in a green box. So I have a big pedal collection, and when we released the Muffaletta, this was always originally in the lineup. I have a few more ideas, but the Muffaletta's been massively successful. It's the best-selling fuzz on reverb, and now this is phase two. It is 9 of my favorite Tube Screamers from my personal collection, perfectly modeled, replicated exactly with all analog parts. I even replicated the drift of the old parts.
Oh, really?
So, yeah, it's like you can't just pull up a schematic of an 808 on the internet, build it, and expect it to sound like it's from 1982. It won't work. So we use audio precision analyzers, all kinds of nerdy spaceship equipment. And we replicated these identically.
Oh man, well thanks so much for taking the time to talk to me about it. I can't wait to play these pedals.